Hi there, myself Rakesh and I welcome you to ExpoHub channel. Today we are into exercise number 38 and let's learn what is there in this exercise. What if this is a question being asked? Do you know the answer? So with that, let's get started. And in case you are a new visitor to our channel and you have not subscribed to our channel, let me tell you why you should subscribe to our channel. And here are a couple of messages which you can pause and read them in case you are interested. And here are a few more. And how you can take maximum benefit of our channel. To take maximum benefit of our channel, we have something called the playlist and the videos. So these are the two places you must visit by going to our channel homepage and watch how many contents we have built for you to learn UiPath, and you can take benefit of all those chapters. Okay, so with that, let's get started and understand the exercise. Okay, so here are two tables given to you and this is the question for you. And the question is, consider above two tables. So all you have to do is design the simple table having employee ID, name, job location, employee ID, gender, blood group, weight. So these are the two tables, simply design on your Excel file. So once you have these two tables, what will be the output if I use join data table? So join data table concept, you should be pretty clear. So if you are using join data table, what is the output? If I use inner join, if I use left join, if I use full join, what are the outputs? So look at this. So what is happening in this data? 1001, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So if you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, until 5, all the data is perfect. Here you have one extra data called 6, right? This the 7th row has extra data. And similarly, in the health chart, here also you have an extra data. So this data is not present here and this data is not present here. So in such a scenario, if I'm using an inner join, what is the output? If I use a left join, what is the output? If I use a full join, what is the output? So these are pretty simple. In case you are hearing it for the very first time, let me tell you, if you continue with me, this is going to be pretty simple. But if you are not aware, I think this is a good lesson for you to know and be aware of what would be the output. If this question is asked, you must answer it correctly. Okay, so let's get started. Before that, after completing the exercise, I always say you to mark yes. And in case you are a new visitor to our channel, please do subscribe. All right, so with that, let's go back to our studio and get started. First of all, what I'm doing, I've created in the same sheet you can do, you can use multiple Excel files. So what I have done is to simplify, sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3 I have created. Sheet 3 I have left it blank. In the sheet 1, I have that first data where I have, this is a extra data which is not present on this one, and here this is the extra data which is not present in first one. And sheet 3 is blank so that I can write the output. Okay. Alright, so let's see what's going to happen. So it's pretty simple. All I have to do is read the first sheet, read the sheet 2. After reading the first sheet, I'm storing in DT1. Reading the second sheet, storing in DT2. I think this is pretty common in all our previous exercises. Okay. Now the first thing is I am using a join data table activity. Okay. And here what I'm going to do, I'm going to experiment with three different situations. So my input data table is DT1 I have created. And the second data table is DT2 and the output is DT3. Okay, the output is going to return in DT3. The first thing I am going to use is inner join. Okay, and how it will join, what is the common data to join? There has to be something in common, right? Otherwise you don't join. So the common, the unique data is your employee ID. Correct. So using employee ID, I am going to join. So column table 1 employee ID, column table 2 employee ID. Okay, whatever the name you have given, but there's a unique data which is a common in, that's why you wanted to join, right? So that you have the all the data as an output. So in such a case, if I'm using inner, what happens? So let me tell you, when I'm using inner, let me not tell you, let me show you. So let me close this file and run it. So here I have selected inner, and if I run it now, and see the output I'm storing in DT3, and I'm simply writing the output in sheet 3. This is quite simple. So let me run it. So what will happen, tell me? So inner join means it is going to match it is only going to show you the output only for the matched data. So here on the first data, if you see, this is not there. So this won't come as a result because this is not there in data 2. Even in data 2, this one is not there in data 1. So this is also not going to be an output. So they will exclude anything which is not matching, it will be excluded. So let's see. Let's go back and open the file and see the output. So I'll go to sheet 3. So what happened? You see the 6 number has not come. Even the extra data which was there in this one, this is also has not come. Getting it? Only the matching data has come. It has joined employee ID name. So data 1, data table 1, entire data has come except that extra data which was not there. Similar way for data table 2, all the data has come except that data which was not there in data table 1. Getting it? So the concept here is, if anything which is not there in one another, those data will not come. Is it clear? Inner join is clear. Okay, now let's see. Let me delete this. And here let me use full join. Sorry, left join. So left means what? Left means it is going to keep all the data in the left, the first data table. So if you see the join wizard, it tells you input data table 1, input data table 2. So 1 is the left one, 2 is the right one. That is how you can picturize. So when I am saying left means all the data in the data table 1 should be kept, even though it is not matching, and it should have a null value. So I am going to show you that. So it is going to be there. So all the data, whatever is there in data table 1, I want it. So in such a case, I'll be selecting a left join. Okay. Now if I do a left join, what will happen? What will be the output? Let me delete the data. Let's quickly run it. Getting it. So I want the left data table. Okay. So I want the data table 1. So if I go to the output now, you see, This 10,000 or 1,06,000. So this has come, right? 1,06,000. This data has come, but the data table 2, which is not matching, that has not come. That means you are giving high importance to the left data table 1. Now you will ask me, Rakesh, what would happen? What would happen if I interchange this? So let's say I'm going to write here DT2, and if I write here DT1. So what would happen here? The left data table is what? DT2. So whatever is there in DT2 will be given priority. So if I run it now and try to check, what would happen? So that 22,06,000, right? That number will come. So let's open the file. Now if you see what has happened, 2005, okay, this data was extra data, right? So this data has come, which was there in data table 2. Okay, so all the data from the data table 2 has come, only the matching data from data table 1 is updated. So this will be your complete output. Getting it? So you are giving precedence to a given data table. If you are interchanging whatever you have kept in the first data table 1, that becomes your left. Okay, so this is understood. So what if, let me put it back to same way, DT1 DT2. And what if I do full means what? It is quite understood now. Full means even the left DT1 will come if there is extra data, and the right one will also come, and whatever the blank fields, it will going to put a null value. So what is a null value? I need to show you, right? So what is happening, if you see, this is a null value. There is no value been kept. So it is automatically, it will assign null value, means no value. So the data will come from DT data table, and the rest of the data which is not matching will have a null value. Okay, so that is the meaning of null value. So let me delete this and let's see the output of full join. So I've kept as full join already. Let me run it. So this is quite simple. Inner join means only the matching data from both the data tables will come. Left means only the left data table, whatever is there, everything will come, and the matching data of DT2 will come. And full means everything from both the data tables will come. Quite easy, right? So let's see the output. Full, like full means. So if you see, data table 1 has come and the rest of the data has been left blank, and data table 2 has come and the rest of the data has been left blank. That's the output. So this gives you a complete understanding of a joint data table. Now the next interesting question will come to your mind. Rakesh, what is the difference between joint data table and merge data table? Merge means what? Join means what? Confused? I already taught you, but you are confused. No worry. If this is a question that comes to your mind, please watch my next exercise. I'm going to clarify that. Thank you so much for watching this. We'll meet again. Bye-bye.